So here we are. We set up some hotkeys, we looked around the interface a little bit, and now what? Well, marking menus and the hotbox are pretty much the next place to look. Inside of Maya, if I hold down the space bar, I have my hotbox. My hotbox is basically all the menus that I could have, all these individual tabs, and you notice when you change through these guys, the menus change as well. But they actually all exist right here. So if I just click in the interface and then hold down my space bar, you'll see that I've got various different things. The common tools, view shading rendering panels, my polygons, NURBS, particles, etc. In addition to this, if I just click, I'm just holding down my left mouse button here, I have the ability to change the current view into a variety of different views here, as well as change the hotbox style. I have a list of recent commands, things that I've done recently, and then hotbox controls, showing and displaying, stuff like that are coming up here. So really you have a lot of different elements right at your tip of your mouse. The next one, which is more common, is right-clicking, of course, and this is going to be based on whatever object you have. Here I have a polygon object, and so I'm getting things like edge, vertex, face, etc. If I were to right-click on, say, a NURBS object, I would get a different set of options. And then, of course, common requirements for this specific object. And that's one of the more common things that you're going to be using there. In addition to that kind of context-sensitive idea, if I were to go ahead and go, say, to face mode, and if I hold down the shift and then right mouse button, I'll get a series of options relating to faces. So I have option of smooth faces, I have my extrude faces, poke faces, basically a whole bunch of polygon modeling tools relating to faces. And if I went to my edge mode and shift right click, you'll notice that I've got a series of edge related options there. In addition to this, I'm just going to go back to my face mode here. I'm going to shift right click, I'll go to extrude face. Now that I'm in the extrude face mode, if I hold down control shift right mouse button, I've got options relating to that specific tool. So each tool that you go into, additional options can be found just by right click and then control shift. Now that doesn't mean that they're exclusive to that menu, they're existing throughout here. But one of the things that people like to do inside of Maya, once they're really comfortable, is basically to turn a lot of the interface off to get maximum real estate. So of course, we can hit control space bar and that will basically eliminate most of the interface. Control space bar again, we'll bring it back. Just another visual tool, Alt B will change your background color should you desire to have a different kind of background color to work with. So what are some of the other marking menus? So some of the more or less common marking menus that probably people will be using. Q, left mouse button, will bring up a selection related tools. Q is your hotkey for going into selection mode. W is your hotkey for the move tool. And again, if you hold down W, and then hold down your left mouse button, you get a series of options for that. Also, E, rotation, hold down your left mouse button, options. R, scale, hold down your left mouse button, and you get options there as well. So a lot of these options, of course, are all the things that you can find here in this menu. They're just right at your fingertips. So what else have we got? If I hold down O, left mouse button, I've got a series of poly brush tools. So poly brush select vertices. It's basically just a radial selection. If I hold down shift, I can add to that selection, or control remove from the selection. So it's basically just a paintbrush selection tool. And basically you have a whole bunch of options here, mesh operations, reduce, clean up to do with those selections that you've now created, modify, flip edges, poke face, etc., cut faces. If I go into poke faces here and I select a bunch of them, it'll go ahead and do that. So this works a little bit differently from the existing tools in that when you use this tool, it will perform that function immediately after you've gone and selected them. So you notice I painted across. Those ones that were selected all got poked with that tool. So that's basically how that one works. Just to stay on the O tool for a moment, if I hold down O and instead I hold down the middle mouse button instead of the left mouse button, you notice that I've got a variety of UV commands. Now these UV commands, of course, are usually used in the UV texture editor. We'll get into that in a different video, but they are available to you directly right here so that you can make use of some of those just in the interface. Now another feature, and I'm just going to go ahead and delete this object, create a few more objects into the scene here. If I go ahead and grab all these guys, right click, go to vertex mode, really just the one that I clicked on goes into vertex mode, which may be nice and sometimes it's really not. Sometimes you want multiple things. You could grab multiples and go into component mode there and then hope that you're in the right mode. And then you can drag across and do this. But a faster way to get to that would be simply grabbing these objects, holding down Alt Q, and then left mouse button, and you can go to vertex, UVs, faces, and edges. So if I wanted to go to vertices, you notice it immediately dumps me into that. So that's just Alt Q to go ahead and get into that tool. More selection related tools also with the Q, Shift Q, and then the left mouse button gives you option for masking off specific things to select. So you choose what kind of things you want to select, what kind of things you don't want to select will be masked out, and then you can use that to try and select specific things. This particular tool set is right here. So we have points, CVs, edges, faces, and so on. So these are your selection masking items there. Object selection masking, so nulls, joints, curves, polygons, lattices, etc. Once you have something selected, sometimes you grab a few things. Maybe something's a little bit easier to select, like, for example, grabbing a loop. If you hold down your control and right click, you can have the option of converting these selections here to something else. So I could convert these selection to faces and grab the faces on either side of that edge, or grab the vertices on that edge set. If I go back to edge mode, hold down control to vertices, and it selects the vertices. So that's just holding down control to modify the selection. Last but not least will be the A left mouse button. And this is our history option. So after we've done some modeling, some changes, and moving stuff around, I have the option to quickly go ahead and delete history or delete non-deformer history in order to access those. So that gives us a lot of the main existing marking menus that are inside of Maya. There are a few others which are really specific to specific tools, but those are the ones that you probably find most useful. Now, I've mentioned already that you can go ahead up in here, at least in another video I did, that you can go ahead and take any one of these tools and dump it to any one of these lines here. So if I want to grab my custom one here, I can create some of my own stuff. And I want to use extract. So it's Control Shift, left mouse button, and it drops it to that menu. Control Shift, average vertices, and drops it there. And of course, if I don't want these anymore, I can middle mouse button, drag them off, and it will delete them from there. Now, these things can be used for another purpose. They sit here and you can go ahead and do what you want. You grab what you want and click the button to make use of it. But these can also be added to your own custom marking menus should you desire. So under Windows Settings and Preferences, Marking Menu Editor, just open the other window here. I have existing marking menus and the ability to create my own custom marking menus. If I create a new marking menu, notice it will give me a setup here where I can go ahead and simply drag and drop slight delay there. Middle mouse button, drag and drop to these different locations, and that will give me my marking menu. Of course, I have to name it as well. And you notice as I click here, my left mouse button, you notice it shows up. And should I desire to add any more, go. And you click and you can see that these guys will start to show up. So that's basically how you can create your own custom marking menus within here. So let's just save that. It's going to show up here. Options of where we want to use it. So let's just set that to hotkey. I'm going to go ahead settings, close, Windows settings and preferences, hotkey editor. And there it is, user marking menus. And there I have it. Press and release. I can choose what key I want to use it for. It's already been set up to use the left mouse button. And that's basically it. You will have your new marking menu for you to use for whatever you like. So that's basically it for what we have with regards to marking menus. Of course, there's lots of other right-click features that exist in here. When you go into Maya and you start working with various different things, if you right-click on them, you'll notice that you'll have a series of options. So right-click features are really quite prevalent throughout the entire Maya interface. So like you saw here, I have the ability to set key or apply a driven key or create an expression. All to drive with this and drive it with the texture. So that's the Maya interface. This is basically the interaction model that you want to be using while working within Maya to get the most out of it. So hopefully that was helpful, and that's it.